So did you get the correct answer? The best choice here is E, optic nerve sheath meningioma. So let's look at some of the features that make choice E the best answer here. First of all, you do see an abnormal enhancement surrounding the left optic nerve. And when I see an orbital lesion, one of the first things that I do is determine the lesion's relationship to optic nerve. Does it coming from the optic nerve itself, or is it coming from outside the optic nerve? It's the same approach that I use when I look at a brain lesion. The first thing I want to see is whether or not the lesion is intraaxial or is extraaxial. Or when I deal with spinal lesion, one of the first things that I want to decide is whether or not the lesion is intramedullary or extramedullary. So here clearly you can see a lesion that's outside of the optic nerve. On the axial view, you can appreciate that the enhancement is parallel to each other, look like a track, so the so-called train track sign on the axial view. On the coronal view, the enhancement is circumferentially surrounding the optic nerve. The non-enhancing central portion is the nerve itself, look like a donut, so donut sign. The enhancement is homogeneous, and you can see that the optic nerve itself is not involved, so it does not enhance and is not expanded, unlike, say, glioma. So overall, the best choice here is E, optic nerve sheath meningioma. What about other answers that doesn't work as well in this case? So for choice A, optic neuritis, that should be involvement of the optic nerve. In an acute phase, you should see expansion of the optic nerve and as well as enhancement. And clearly, you don't see that. And remember, they can ask you about optic neuritis and its association with MS on board exam. For choice B, venous malformation, that's orbital hemangioma. Typically, they present with a heterogeneous enhancing mass that's retroorbital, often cause quite a bit of mass effect on the optic nerve and on the surrounding structure. Again, this lesion right here is circumferential enhancement, so not the typical appearance for hemangioma. Choice C, optic nerve glioma, such as you often see that with NF1 in younger patient, and that again is derived from the optic nerve, and you see expansion of the optic nerve and sometimes it enhances. So choice C is not it. And for choice D, thyroid orbitopathy or Graves' disease, you should see symmetric or bilateral enlargement of the extraocular muscle. Remember the mnemonic I am slow. That's a mnemonic for progression of the enlargement in a classic pattern. And often you see expansion or enlargement of the orbital fat volume causing bilateral proptosis. So we don't see that here. So answer E is the best choice here. Best luck on your study. Have a good day.